Hello guys, welcome back to the Civil Engineering YouTube channel. Please subscribe our channel for daily Civil Engineering videos. Today our lecture is about the Earthquake Engineering Terminologies. So in this lecture, I will define and explain some of the terms used in the Earthquake Engineering. These are the fault, the focus are the hypocenter, the epicenter, the focal depth, and the epicentral distance. So I will explain one by one with the help of this diagram. So first of all, to define the fault, a fault can be defined as a surface inside the earth, across which two blocks can move relative to each other. So it means it is the surface where the two blocks of the earth can move across one each other, right? Let's consider this the one rock and this is the another rock. These are my two rocks considered. So these rocks allow to move against one another. So this surface is known as the fault. So let's suppose this is the earth diagram. This is the earth surface. You can see here above is the earth surface. Like this is the earth surface, while below here is the inside the earth. So this is the fault. You can see the fault line where the blocks can move against each other. The two rocks can move against one each other. And due to the movement of these two rocks, what happens? The earthquake happens. So that's why this is known as the fault line. So fault can be defined as a surface across which two earth blocks can move relative to each other, and due to this moment the earthquake happens. So this was the fault. Now the second one is the focus or the hypocenter. These are the synonym of one another, focus or hypocenter. So it can be defined as the point on the fault where the slip starts. So it is the point on the fault, like this is the fault line, for example, this is the fault. You can see here this is the fault. So the point on the fault where your slip starts, where your movement of slip starts, so this point is known as the focus or the hypocenter. The next one is the epicenter. Epicenter can be defined as the point on the earth surface directly above the focus. Epicenter, you can see here, epicenter, this is the point which is the above the focus, but directly above the focus, right? You can see here the focus here, and above the focus directly on the earth surface, this point is known as the epicenter. So epicenter is the point on the earth surface directly above the focus. This is the focus inside the earth. So this point directly on the earth surface, this point is known as epicenter, which is on the earth surface. You can see here the epicenter is above the focus. Now the focal depth, it is very simple, the depth of the focus from the epicenter. So this distance from the focus up to the epicenter, this depth is known as the focal depth. The focus is below the inside of the earth and the epicenter is above the earth surface directly. So this distance between these two, this is known as the focal depth, right? Now what is the epicentral distance? Let's suppose that we are interested that there is some earthquake. We want to know about the earthquake information here. So there is some building, right? So the distance from the epicenter to our point of interest where we find the earthquake terms, right? So this distance is known as the epicentral distance. The distance from the epicenter to our point of interest where we want to find the magnitude of the earthquake, so are the other waves. So this distance from the epicenter to our point of interest is known as this distance, right? This distance is known as the epicentral distance. So these were the all points in the earthquake engineering terminologies. These were the basic points, right? In the coming videos, I will explain the other advanced terms used in the earthquake engineering. So it was the introductory topic about the earthquake engineering. Hope you guys understand. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for daily civil engineering videos. Thank you for watching our video.